Received information about the riot that has broken out downtown. Police have released the identities of four young rock and rollers who were believed to have instigated the riot. Their names are as follows: a young singer, Kevin DeBrow; drummer, Drew Forsythe; bassist, Rudy Sarzo; and a young man whose volume is believed to have caused the disturbance, guitarist Randy Rhodes. Collectively, they are known as Riot Riot. We now take you to the scene.
Watch your life, your attention, all right. It's left, no, you're not a day. Thank you. it. It's getting hot. You don't mind if I take my jacket off, do you? Anyways, we're going to carry on now with a little song that Randy wrote. It's called Breaking Up. It's a heartache. A 1, 2, 3, 4.
We'll
Fletcher. Dr. Hal Fletcher. Well, now then, he comes to a part of our show, and we get to show all Randy Rhoads off a little bit. What do you think? Yeah? Well, let me tell you. I've heard some guitar players, well, well, but I ain't heard not too many like the incredible Randy Rhoads. And he's gonna bring you a little song. It's called Laughing Gas.
Thank you.
Yeah. something. You're all on TV tonight. You see, you got cameras all over the place, and you're filming it for TV. It's going to be on the cable. So, you say you're doing a great job. You sound a lot better than we do. I mean, not that we sound bad, but you sound incredible. Yeah. I would like to thank you for a really incredible birthday party as well. For the old man that I am. And I would also like to say, there's a lot of people going around saying that New Wave is the only thing that's going to happen in the 80s. Well, there's a lot of people in the Starwood tonight that says that isn't true, isn't it? That's what I thought, yeah, yeah. And to those people who say that's the only thing that's going to happen, I say, up yours, man, there's room for everything. Yeah. Now then, just to refresh your memories once again, the delightful Rudy Sarzo on bass. Who doesn't perspire? Never. Chino, his 5 day never wears off. And the immaculate Drew Forsythe on drums. And once again, listen, hey Sailor, are you new in town? Randy Rhodes on the guitar. Who am I? Let him tell you. You wonder who I am, man. You remember? Now, I've been telling who I am for a long time. He keeps forgetting, though. But, with a bottle of Heineken in one hand and a megaphone in another, I would like to say to you, ladies and gentlemen, we would like to hear a song called Back to the Cars!
You are the star and back. I don't even want to start it.
Where do I look? You at the banner or the camera?
Either way.
Just be natural.
Well, I'll tell you, I enjoy being in choir riot, especially talking about love.
Nothing. Okay, I'm here with several members of the group Quiet Riot. Here I have Randy, the lead guitar player, Kevin, the lead singer, and Drew, the drummer. All right, how are you guys all doing tonight?
Pretty
good?
Super
fun. All right. First of all, I'd like to ask you guys, are you guys all originally from LA, Los Angeles area? Or do you come from different, like a different state or something?
Different state of mind.
To stay in LA, you have to be, I guess.
Is everyone from California?
Yep.
Okay, that's me. As far as education and music go, how have you guys all had a little bit of that?
Well, these two are the big virtuoso experienced musicians, so Randy should tell you about his own background.
I studied cello, violin, flute, saxophone.
Too much?
No.
What?
No, I haven't had much background.
You haven't had too much. Kevin, how about you?
I taught him everything he knows.
No. I played drums when I was younger and then just decided to start singing with some help from my personal vocal coach, Master Rose.
I became the virtuoso that you said I'll see you today.
Drew? Anything?
Lots of
background.
Too numerous to mention, of course. No. I went to Europe with a marching band, as a matter of fact.
When you were how old?
When I was 18.
18.
But Randy here, maybe doesn't have all the background, but if you'd ask his 60 students, you know, they Seven.
So you teach lessons, guitar lessons?
Mm-hmm. All right. Randy has the distinction of being, I think, the most popular guitar teacher in California as far as number of students that you teach.
Don't be modest.
He's overworked and underpaid.
You enjoy it, obviously.
Yeah, I love it.
Great.
Yeah, I should talk to him when he gets home each night.
Okay, can you guys give me some history of the band, how you all met, or were you all with previous bands? Were any of you with previous bands?
Kevin and Randy were both in jail, and they met,
seriously.
Sharing the toilet.
Yeah.
How did you guys all meet?
Well, Randy, we had an original bass player. Randy had played in many bands with him before, and, thank you. Huh? Oh no, that's my camera. You can edit this, right? And Randy had been through many singers and heard about me through a telephone conversation with some strange girl. Gave me a ring one day, and Randy had played with Drew in a lot of their bands. He's doing that too. They played with Drew in high school, right? Thank you. Thank you, dude. And,
but now we're all straight. I met Kevin at a VD clinic.
How long have you guys been together as Quiet Riot?
6 months.
What time is it?
We'll be together, 5 years in April.
Tell me when that gets to 600 counter.
5 years?
When it gets
in
to 600,
April.
The counter. When it gets to 600, tell me when it gets to 600.
Kelly.
What? What?
Kelly.
A friend of mine was in an English band called Status Quo, and we had a different name at the time that I met him. I told him the name we had, and he didn't like it real well, and gave me the name Quiet Riot, and I brought it to a rehearsal that night, and everybody liked it and thought it suited our style real well.
Is there any background to that? I mean, was there a certain reason?
Well, they were, Status Quo was going to call it their album, Quiet Riot, their latest album at the time, which was about 5 years ago. So they decided not to, and he says, well, if I had a band now, I would call them Quiet Riot.
And you guys just said, fine.
I said, great, sounds good.
Okay.
It's better than the name we had.
Okay.
And it suited a lot of
What was the name you had?
Rockers?
It seemed to suit the image. I mean, as soon as we got the name, every time we played somewhere, there was a huge fight. The first gigs we ever played, there was a brawl on stage.
See, what happened is every time Randy would get a beer, he'd go up to some guy who was like 6'6", and like 250 pounds, and went, hey, mother. And of course, the guy would go, that's why he's so small.
You're gonna do a lot of problems there.
No.
Okay, I'd like to gear some questions towards the music you play. I've heard comments here and there about sounding like Queen. Do you guys mind sounding like them?
No, I think you got the question wrong. People have called us Queens. That's probably where you heard that, you know?
Not anything about sounding like the group.
No, nothing like that.
David Forrest won't like that at all.
No. So that is just...
No, it's, a lot of people make that comparison.
I've heard
it for five years.
Yeah.
Have you? What do you guys think about that?
Doesn't bother me in the least.
Directly nonsense.
Why would you say nonsense?
Well, because we don't have any guitar players. I can see the comparison. I mean, great guitar players, great drummers, great singers, you know. A lot of the same ideas are in both groups.
Did Queen influence you at all as far as what